Don't miss out on the special offer from my sponsor, Buy Madden Coins. They're currently giving you 20% off if you use my coupon code POODLE at checkout, and also giving you an additional 10% coins at checkout. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. And today we got Madden 20. It is finally out, guys. But the only issue I'm having right now, literally the only issue, is that I can't get on my main account. I think it has to do for a lot of you guys, when you have the game already pre-ordered on the Xbox store, a lot of those people can't seem to get it. So I made a side account just so I'd be able to play Madden 20. My side account got the free trial. Sadly, my main account can't right now, but I'll be making plenty of tip videos, plenty of things going over Madden 20 until then. But the second I get my account back, I'm going to drop probably a bundle, guys. If you can get this video to 50 likes, I will drop a bundle on my main account the second I'm able to. I have it all ready. I have the money ready, loaded up to go the second I can get onto it. But guys, this video is going to be about some advice to give you guys on how to handle the day one of Madden in the auction block. Because I know a lot of guys always make this common mistake. You guys are all going to be pulling a lot of good elites today. I do not recommend selling the majority of them, guys. Before I get into my advice and my tips for the auction, if you're new to the channel, guys, make sure to sub, comment, and like. Madden 20 season is officially here. So make sure to like, comment, and make sure to sub. We're getting the season underway. Gonna try to pick up some momentum and hopefully record about 8 videos today. Have 4 ready for tomorrow. If you guys smash the like button and show a lot of support, I will be dropping a bundle opening hopefully today. And then if you guys smash the like button on that one, I'll drop another one tomorrow so you guys can see plenty of pulls. I also have a fantasy pack waiting on this account. So stay for the video. I'll be opening it later. I've seen some pretty good pulls out of these packs, so hopefully I can get some. And if it goes out well, I'll just trade it over to my main account. Or sell it and give myself the coins, whatever. Maybe I'll give it away. So actually, guys, yeah, let's do that. If this video gets to 50 likes, I'll give away 10K coins. Which in the beginning of the game is kind of a lot. You guys already know the routine. 50 likes, and I'll give away 10K coins. So a random commenter. So all you gotta do is comment down below. And if you guys smash it to 100, I'll give away 10K and I'll drop a bundle. Now guys, first things first for the channel. First video of Madden 20, my advice. So obviously the auction block isn't opening right now. There's a reason for that. And that is because solo challenges aren't playable right now. It's a lot of glitchiness going on right now. So a lot of people can't even play solo challenges. And the only way you get the auction block open is by playing solo challenges. So as you can see, you need to be level 3 and a lot of people can't. The only people who can are people who had the game early and already leveled up. But now that the games are out, I'm just showing you guys these packs real quick while they're here. So we got the 24 times gridiron bundle. That is the bundle I will be opening as soon as possible. Now hopefully I can get some bangers out of there. But the first bit of advice, guys, don't sell what you get right away. That's the biggest thing I can emphasize right now, because in Madden, the first week of EA Access, I've learned from experience, never sell things the first week. So let's say you pull Tom Brady, right, 88 overall. Probably goes for like 120K, 200K. When the official Madden 20 comes out, it might go for 400K. Because the thing is, the first week, not many people have it yet. Not many people can even get in right now, let alone play it. I'm one of the few that can actually get in right now. So if you can get in and you're able to buy packs, think about it. If you sell it, there's less people actually putting things up, so there's less competition. There's less people to even buy. Imagine that too. So let's say there's like 5 Tom Brady's, right? But there's not that many people buying. Trust me, just the way the market works, I would wait for almost everything. Maybe a few gold cards you could sell if you really want the coins now, but there's really no reason. I wouldn't even touch the auction block until the official game is out. That's how I usually run it. I pull packs the first week, I sit on players, I enjoy the game, making videos, and then when it comes time to actually have the official game out, that is when I will work on auctioning my team and doing what I gotta do. Now, I also have a surprise thing to show you guys in the bundle opening, guys, so make sure you guys go watch that video when it comes out. So smash this like button to 100 for that bundle opening, and then also 50, and comment down below if you guys want 10K. So as far as the auction goes, don't touch it right now. You could go look at it, do what you want, but that's even if you can get onto it, I wouldn't recommend it. Also, guys, some more tips on what to do right now. If you guys are no money spent, obviously the solos on the move, but they're not really playable. I can show you guys them real quick, but they're not exactly touchable right now. I mean, there's this ultimate challenge, which is very useful. I'll go over that in another video. But if you guys can't get into there, the best thing you could do right now is, I think the only thing you do is pop packs, but obviously not everyone wants to do that. So my best advice is try maybe the Welcome to Ultimate Team Challenge. Solo battles isn't live. You can maybe do head-to-head. So guys, based off what I already know on how overalls will be working this year and how things are supposed to go for this beginning of Madden, elites are going to be a lot lower overalls than in years past to start. So remember, anything from an 82 and 84 is a lot more valuable than it has been in years past. An 84 overall is more like an 86 from last year. An 86 overall is more like an 88 from last year. An 88 is like a 90. So you have to remember that too. So like if you get an 88 pull, it's more valuable than it really seems off the bat if you're used to Madden 19. So that's why I would just wait. Wait until the market settles out and you know value, because right now things are like, I remember last year or 2 years ago, I pulled an AJ Green the first week and I went to go sell it. For like, it was like going for like 140-ish and I didn't end up selling it. I waited on it. I was going to, but it wasn't selling, so I just waited. The following week, it was like 240 when the game came out. Things tend to rise up when there's a lot. People are going to come into this game fast, start getting coins, start buying cards out, start holding cards for their teams. So I'd wait. Also, if you have the team right now, you could also enjoy the game a little bit, play some head-to-head, level up, try to pick up your team up. Also, you want to get your mutt level up. That's a big part of it, too. But guys, let me start getting into this fantasy pack. I have it sitting here. I think I've decided on the team I'm going to be going. I don't know, should I do Chiefs or Cowboys? Chiefs or Cowboys? Chiefs or Cowboys? I want Mahomes. No, but... Fuck. Do I go Chiefs or Cowboys? I'm going Chiefs. I'm going Chiefs, come on. Please, give me Mahomes. That's a silver. Dude, you can get silvers in this? That's a silver. Gold, no. Gold. Damn, got nothing. I watched someone pull Zeke out of these earlier. Oh, crap. Okay. I was hoping for Mahomes, but I got some players. I'll show you guys a little bit of the team overlay of what we can see on the team real quick before I get into this. I'm trying to show you guys as much as I can while I'm waiting for my account to come up. So don't forget, guys. Just be careful with the auction block. Hopefully, this game's up for everyone soon to do some solos. All right, guys. And lastly, would I recommend these packs right here? Like I said, because these are obviously the only ways you're really going to get these elite players right now, would I recommend them? See these right here? Click on them. They are 12,000, and if you look at the pack odds, there's an 85 or better players, 5.2%, which is kind of low. 83 is only 13, and 80 plus is 39, which means that every other pack or so, you should be getting an elite realistically with the multiple players per pack. It is less than last year. Last year was 40 total packs, but these are gridiron packs, it says, which aren't even regular, which makes a little more sense. So I guess, I don't know if they're all called gridiron now. Yeah, I guess they're just known as gridiron packs or the standard packs now. Maybe get a gold player is like the old type of packs now. But would I recommend it? If you're no money spent, I guess not. But if you're going to spend money, this is like the only bundle to pop right now. There's also the elite player packs with the 87s being a 3.4. So the odds are definitely a little better on the elite player packs. But the difference is these packs are about $10 per. And the gridiron packs are $5 per. So they kind of equal out. The only difference is these are guaranteed elites. But if you open up $100 worth of these and you could pull straight 80s or vice versa. You could pull 24 of these. I mean, it comes out, but you also get three elite player packs here. So it's probably the best value for you right now. These aren't bad either, but these are 10 elites versus about, you probably get about 10 elites minimum on this thing too. So it's going to be about equal, but the only difference is the gridiron packs. I feel like I don't know. It's very close. I mean, it's all kind of preference at this point, I guess. These come with an elite player, 270 gold plus players, two additional 66 plus overall. So I guess the hitting chance is kind of similar. I mean, I guess they're all very similar. I mean, three elites guaranteed, one elite guaranteed, 102 golds. So definitely a lot more gold or betters. So these are probably the better way to go. Because if you times this by 10, it'll only be 20 gold or betters. If you times this by, it already is like that. So I'd probably recommend the Gridiron Pack Guys bundle. That is about it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this is somewhat relevant to you guys right now. And if you guys are new to the channel, please make sure to like. Drop the like. Let's get to 50 to 100 likes or even more if we can. I already told you below early in the video what that's about. Open up the fantasy pack. And I also have a little special thing that I got sent in the mail from another YouTuber that I'm going to be showing in the bundle. So make sure to drop a like so I can drop that video. And don't forget to subscribe. We're trying to build momentum up. We're trying to get our names out there in Madden 20. And last but not least, be careful. Be careful with the block. Don't know the worth of your cards. Don't be the impatient person that sells right now just because they want to sell their first card in a Madden team and have coins to show their friends. Just don't bother with it. Don't save your coins. Save your cards. Be smart. Enjoy the cards for this week. And then when the game officially comes out and you know the worth of every card, then sell them. Because I know myself personally, I'd be very mad if I'm the person that sells Pat Mahomes for 180K, 200K, and he ends up going for 500K being the best quarterback. I would not be taking that chance, guys. That's about it, guys. Hope you guys have enjoyed. Hope we can get our name out there, Madden 20. Hope I can get my account soon so I can drop this bundle. I'm dying to drop this bundle for you guys. And that's about it. I'm out. See you guys later.